setting the stage for the run to the finish. Caution is out for the ninth time today. Stanton Barrett, the American Ford, into the wall in turn two.
Big break for Matt Kenseth.
Bad break for Kurt Busch.
Bad break for teammate. They may end up racing each other.
Yeah, because what we have right now, with probably about 30 laps to go when we get restarted, we have Kurt Busch in the 97, Rusty Wallace in second in the two car, Sterling Marlin in the 40. They all are approaching that 100-lap mark on their tires. Jimmy Johnson behind them in the 48. He has about 20 less laps, but I want to tell you, the cat to watch is back there in fifth right now, Kevin Harvick. He came to pit road just about 20 to 25 laps ago. He has the fresher tires of all this group.
And he's been working right up through there. So we got some cars back here that are going to be coming on.
Kurt Busch is saying, guys, please behave. I don't need any more cautions.
Stanton Barrett, way up top of your screen, up and into the wall at turn. There will be pit stops. Jimmy Johnson, Michael Waltrip, Greg Biffle, then Mayfield, Jarrett, Sadler, and Earnhardt.
They took a note out of what Matt Kenseth did. I think that's a good move.
Steve?
Well, guys, Jimmy Johnson's saying he's just a little bit too tight, so they'll put four tires on, 1.5 rounds in the right rear tire to take care of that tight problem. Left side tires going on. Corey Quick and Joe Sandolini, good job again for the 48.
Now coming around to the front stretch side are Biffle, Sadler, and Earnhardt. Johnny Sauter also pitted. Dick?
Well, Greg Biffle had been running in the ninth position. The car was just a little bit tight. They decided nothing to lose, a lot to gain, so they'd come in to fire four new tires at it and see if it'll run better on those. To Matt.
Dale Earnhardt Jr. in. This will be a four-tire change. Going to make a track bar adjustment. Troy Prince made the adjustment. As the left sides go on, no fuel for Dale Earnhardt Jr. doesn't need it, he's down and away.
We hear Jimmy Johnson's going to come back in, be fixed. Terry Labonte comes in. He will be the free pass car, will be the final car on the lead lap when we go back to green in 20th position.
I tell you, I just believe the cars we better keep a watch on is Kevin Harvick in that 29 and Matt Kenseth in that 17, fourth, fifth position. And Jimmy Johnson just about missed his pit box back there. Those guys, they have literally no laps on their tires, Darrell. And remember, Kurt Busch, Rusty Wallace, Sterling Marlin, 100 laps.
Hero, zero. Remember last week?
Yes.
Got him out of the pit, he wins the race. Today, he had a shot at winning the race until a loose lug nut.
Well, we said we'd be with you to the finish. That, of course, assumed green flag condition. These drivers take pit stops. Let's take a quick one. We'll be back for the restart. Accidents will happen, 9 of them so far here at Bristol Motor Speedway, and still 32 laps to run. Kurt Busch, Rusty Wallace, Sterling Marlin. As our Quaker State aerial coverage shows, no traffic on Highway 11E outside Bristol Motor Speedway. This is the kind of place where nobody goes home until it's over.
And you better not go home when it's over, because it could get interesting down in the infield of this racetrack.
Yeah, we haven't had any real temper tantrums today other than Tony there early on. But so many things are setting up here, guys. The 97 and the 40. There's Mark Martin up there. Remember what happened at Rockingham when his teammate was leading the race on the restart? He got called to the big red truck, the Oval Office.
Right. Darrell, you've won here 9 times. What do you do in this situation? You're Kurt Busch. You've got the lead. You got 32 laps to go. You got worn tires. What do you do?
I don't know, but if Hammond was down there, what he'd be doing, he'd be eating ice cream right now. And we'd be getting ready to go to Victory Circle.
But I tell you what, I like Kevin Harvick in that 29, Matt Kenseth in that 17. I don't know if they're going to have enough laps, but they do have fresh tires, and Kurt Busch has 100 laps on his tires.
Here's what it looks like from the best seat in the house, high above Bristol Motor Speedway at suite level 2. looking down on 160,000 fans and what's left of this 43-car field, going to settle it out here over the final 30 laps. Matt.
Dale Earnhardt Jr. will restart from the 16th position, 30 laps to get it done. Tony Sr., a lot of conversation, not happy that they are blowing the track off.
Well, they raced on the track dirty all day. They blew it one time to get down here to end the race whenever they could put a race on. Now they won't blow their track and waste 10 or 15 laps riding around here with a pace car out there. So, seems like they want to do it every week here lately. I don't know what their problem is. You come in, make a pit stop, put tires on, think you're going to go out there and do something, and they won't sit out and ride around for 20 laps while they blow the rubber on the racetrack. I don't know what their problem is.
In fact, Dale Earnhardt Jr. said they might as well just open the gate and let traffic come in too. Chris?
All right, and Jeff, your thoughts on those comments, former crew chief yourself.
Well, what's going on right now, Chris, as far as Tony Sr., what he's trying to explain is that they've got themselves in a situation where they need a lot of green flag racing, and NASCAR is basically taking that away from them, and he's not happy about that. He wants to go racing. He feels like he's got a good race car, had a little bit of a problem. They've got it fixed. He wants that opportunity to try to make up some ground. So basically, guys, what I'm telling you to do right now is roll them sleeves up and get ready. We're at Bristol. These last few laps are going to be wild and woolly.
All right, another veteran crew chief, Jimmy Fenech. He's the guy for Kurt Busch, and he's standing by with Dick Berggren. Dick?
Yeah, Jimmy, we've just heard from another crew chief who thinks they shouldn't blow the racetrack off. We've got caution here. You're leading the race. What do you think?
Well, NASCAR's doing what they need to do. I mean, there was stuff out there. We'll just see what happens at the end here. Kurt's doing an awesome job.
Okay, good luck to you. Mike?
Things look pretty good when the only thing in front of you is the pace car, Darrell.
You know what? We used to say when we come here, boys, this is where you put your work clothes on right here. Got work to do.
Yes, sir.
Ninth caution flag. It's going to be 28 laps to run as they line up double file for the restart. Kurt Busch is your leader, trying to three-peat. Rusty Wallace is second. Sterling Marlin is third. Kevin Harvick, Matt Kenseth, Jamie McMurray, Kenny Schrader, Ryan Newman, Jeff Gordon, Scott Wimmer, the top 10. There are 20 lead lap cars as we get set to go back to green for hopefully the final 28 laps.
And Rusty Wallace in that two car, he wants to stay hooked right to Kurt Busch in that 97. He'd like to clear Mark Martin before they come off turn two.
And you got to remember now, Mark is trying to be the first car a lap down. He's trying to get a lap back. So, you know, it doesn't matter who's leading the race right now. He's just doing his job.
And the good thing about it right now, Kurt Busch in the 97, our leader, he has clean racetrack in front of him. He can hit his marks and run his groove. But I'm telling you, you can just see Rusty Wallace gripping that steering wheel in two right now.
Well, hungry dog.
He's gnawing on that thing right now. And he's going to be gnawing on that back bumper if he can get to it. He will not take no for an answer. And I believe Sterling Marlin's got a problem.
Kevin Harvick around the outside of Marlin.
Looked like he had a problem. I don't know if he had a checkup down there off of four or what happened, but they got a run on him. I know that.
Rusty Wallace is about two car lengths and 26 laps away from his first win in over 100 races.
And he feels like, you know, Jeff Gordon cost him one here a couple of years ago. And I don't think he wants to let one get away today if he's got a shot. I think something's wrong with Sterling, Larry.
Yeah, look at this battle for third. I think what's wrong, Darrell, is 100-lap tires versus Kevin Harvick's fresh tires. And remember, Matt Kenseth in that 17 right behind him, along with Jamie McMurray, they have fresh tires, too. That's what's wrong with Sterling, but he's not ready
to give up. I think Martin just had a problem, too. He just saw a bunch of smoke fly out of his car. I think they're 48. I think there's oil on the track.
48 and 38 got together. Now everybody straightens out.
We'll see here. I thought there might be some oil from Mark's car.
Boy, Kurt really washed up down in turn one and two, but he got a good run off turn two. They'll be coming back to the line. 22 laps to go.
Mark Martin has slowed up but is still running. We stay under green.
Every time he goes through three and four, though, Mike, I do see some smoke trail out of that race car.
Yeah, something happened to it. I'm not sure exactly what. But in the meantime, back at the ranch.
Rusty got off turn two and got to within a foot of Kurt Busch's rear bumper.
And Darrell, Kurt Busch, he has to hug that yellow line. He can't open that door an inch for Rusty Wallace in that two car.
Just don't overdrive. Float it in. Get back to the throttle quick. He'll never get around you.
That time, Busch beat Wallace back to the throttle off two.
Easy in, hard off.
That's exactly right. Kurt Busch cannot overdrive the entrance to the corner.
Whoa.
And he cannot look in his mirror.
Man, he did something there. Rusty really had a look on the inside going down into one. That was almost a disaster.
20 to go.
Rusty's last win, California, 2001, 103 races ago.
He's got the best chance he's had in a long time to win that race.
And Darrell, he's had a good race car ever since they unloaded.
77.
Caution is out.
Somebody got Brendan gone.
I think it may have been Dale Jr.
I think you may be right. Now, gone also had a tire rub. and he falls from 11th place to the tail end of the lead lap with 19 to go.
Well, he's got serious damage. He hit that inside retaining wall hard.
Everything's still working.
Let's see what happened here.
Got a little smoke there, but that didn't cause him that problem, I don't think.
Definitely looked like Dale Earnhardt Jr. Nate got into the back of
it. Just nailed him, yeah.
He had a tire smoking, but I don't think it had anything to do with what happened.
No, that's just Dale Jr.'s got four fresh tires, and he was in a hurry.
Matt?
Brendan Gaughan telling his crew chief Shane Wilson the steering wheel is still straight, meaning he didn't knock the toe out on that 77 car, although there is considerable cosmetic damage to the whole nose of that machine.
Prior to that, Tony Urie and Dale Jr. have been invited to the Oval Office, DW's hotspot, for conversation. Now they'll have a little more to talk about.
Yeah, I'm sure they didn't appreciate the comments about blowing off the track.
And I would say with 15 to go, they will have a company down there before it's all over.
Oh, yeah.
And Brendan Gaughan, the 77, he still is on the lead lap. Right now, we have 20 cars on the lead lap. Robbie Gordon in the 31 will get the pardon. He'll be back on the lead lap.
But if I was 77, if I was gone, I'd bring that car to pit road and work on it. They don't need to stay out there. He gets under speed, the thing will start rubbing, smoking tires, and there he comes.
He comes along with Mayfield and Labonte, Terry Labonte. Still 20 cars on the lead lap, and the question now is, can we get this race restarted? With more than 10 laps to go, it would be a double file restart. 10 laps or less, it would be a single file restart. Lead lap cars to the front. Which would favor Kurt Busch? Which would favor Rusty?
Quite honestly, Rusty would be better off with a single file restart. Kurt's going to be better off with a double file restart. He gets a little jump, gets some traffic in between him and Rusty. Adios.
Yeah, single file restart. Rusty will not have that car lap down to fight on the inside of Kurt Busch.
Right now, single file, he starts second. When they double up, he starts third.
Kurt Busch trying to make history, win three in a row, and four out of the last five. That's the four-peat we talked about earlier. Rusty Wallace trying to break history, that triple-digit non-winning streak.
And, I got to give a tip of the hat to Rusty. Been working really hard, changing things around, crew members, crew chiefs, trying to get back to victory circle. And man, he's got to be sitting there thinking right now, this is the best opportunity. And there's Larry Boy Carter right there. He worked with me up there at Travis Carter's in 2000. Good guy, good crew chief.
If you weren't with us yesterday, the finish of the race was unbelievably exciting in the NASCAR Busch Series. Let's show it to you right here at Bristol. There's the first bit of trouble. David Stremme into the wall off Kevin Harvick. Then Stremme waits around, and the orange car that comes into view, well, it was Johnny Benson. It wasn't Kevin Harvick, but he and Stremme got together. Benson up into the wall. After the race, Benson comes over to the window for a conversation with David Stremme, which continued on into the Oval Office.
It was very crowded after the race.
What did Michael say? Those guys were mad up in there.
But Mike, you talked about the losing streak of Rusty Wallace in the new car. It would be his 55th career win. It would be Larry Carter's first career win as a crew chief.
Now, don't leave. Just please don't leave. Yesterday, during the last 10 laps of the Busch race, every position from second on back changed.
Yeah, we even had one guy that said, I've had enough and came to pit road early. Before the race even ended, he was running second, ended up 17th.
And I just to follow up on Larry Carter, I remember my first career win back at Watkins Glen in 1988. Matt, what's going on down there in the two pits?
Larry Mack, if they can pull off this win, not only will it be Larry Carter's first win as crew chief, it'll be his first win ever. You think back through all the years of association in NASCAR racing, even with his uncle Travis Carter, he has never, ever gone to a Nextel Cup Series victory lane. Maybe today will be the day as we get ready to restart.
Who will it be? Kurt Busch, Rusty Wallace, and right behind them, Kevin Harvick, Sterling Marlin, point leader Matt Kenseth, Jamie McMurray, Kenny Schrader, Ryan Newman. Here we go.
Rusty spun the tires on the start of the race.
He just spun the tires right there, and I don't know how much it's going to hurt him, but I think with Kevin Harvick on better tires, he better get going.
Attaboy to Tony Stewart. who gave the lead lap cars plenty of room to race.
12 laps to go this time. Kurt Busch, as you say, just don't need to overdrive that corner right now, as he has about a 3-car length lead through one and two.
But Rusty's car, I believe, is a little bit better than Kurt's. It's just the question, can he get to him?
Rusty did get off turn two very good that time. His car is not hooking up off the corner.
I think this is when a driver, it's when you really start trying too hard, Larry. Need to take a deep breath and let it come to you.